The show you're tuned into right now was put together by students and staff enrolled in the broadcasting courses in the radio television department at San Joaquin Delta College.
Yeah, that's real!
The brain is the most complex structure in the known universe.
Welcome back to Unknown Space. I am Thomas Urganda, joined by Alex Salon. This is Season 2, Year of the Fool. Say hi, Alex.
Ungabunga.
That's good enough.
Okay, cool.
So, before we really get into the topic, I want to talk about, you know, us. This is Season 2. We've obviously been 3 months without recording, which I swear it was longer, but we ended off in May, June, July, August.
Dude, it did feel like a long time.
It did. This is weird. like just announcing this whole new project, Year of the Fool, I felt like, yo, people are going to be like, yo, they're back or whatever, but it's like, it's only been 3 months. That's not miraculous at all. This is Unknown Space Radio. This is a show where we overthink out loud for the audience. And,
I even forgot that was our slogan.
Yeah. I felt like I just said that, like, right off the tip of my tongue, but apparently I meant it. But this season, same goal, different mask. We want to kind of normalize overthinking. It's a human process, and no one is ever alone in thoughts or feelings because we exist in that same field with you, and you exist in that same field with us. What do you think, man?
Dude, that felt good to hear.
Yeah?
I hope other people listen and hear the same thing, because that was always our point of the show.
Yeah.
That was always our goal.
Yeah. And here we are, Season 2.
What we're kind of doing different with this season of the show is we kind of want to reach out to people and kind of get like their opinion and have them say like a little snippet of just kind of some of the topics we talk about in each show instead of just being just us every episode.
Yeah, so towards the end of this broadcast, you're going to hear voices that aren't ours. And it's because last season, on the final episode, we did this thing where we reached out to people, and it felt really good, and the end product made us feel good.
I feel like that was the most beautiful episode because we reached out to other people.
Yo, honestly, yeah. Like, just because a lot of it's about us, and it's, like, really nice to hear other people. And some of their, like, words that they're saying was really nice, as opposed to ours being oftentimes negative. Episode 1. Welcome to episode 1. So, over the break, I guess? What?
Nothing.
No, like, just over the break, just in the time we've been away from RTV and Unknown Space, my friend showed me this album. It's called Everywhere at the End of Time by The Caretaker.
Dude, and someone recommended me that.
Dude, that's a
haunt. And I haven't listened to it yet.
It's a very haunting experience. It's a 6-hour long project, and it's kind of sort of to simulate dementia. and memory loss, it's kind of starts out with playing you a set of songs. And through all six stages, it's sort of like the same songs playing over and over, but they get more and more distorted with each stage, because they say in like dementia, music is like the last thing you remember. You could go to people with heavy to severe dementia.
With heavy to severe dementia.
And they'll still be humming like their favorite songs, even though they don't like even know their names and stuff. And basically, I've just been really thinking about just memory loss and stuff like that in general, and how that's going to be not a good experience. You know, someday we won't remember our own names. We won't even know that anyone loves us. We won't even know how to scream. And that's a really scary thing, and especially because I sort of, not that I have it, but I've seen it in like family members. And I kind of have bad memory loss already. Or maybe I'm just forgetful. Maybe there's a difference. But I want to know your thoughts on it. I, for one, am really scared of that day that comes to me. What's your take on it?
I really forgot about how... That's not intended. I really forgot about how dark stuff got in the show and how deep we got with the show. But just when you were saying that like that's just like I felt a sense of like heartbreak.
There's gonna come a day, man.
There's gonna come a day with not just us. I don't know what's scarier, us or our family seeing that. I think if it happens with us, it's like, are we really gonna be, how conscious of it are we really gonna be? Maybe in the beginning. But I think as it starts to get worse and worse, we're not really going to notice. We're not going to be able to remember we're forgetting, you know?
Yeah, that's... See, that takes me back to a question on season one, where I think I asked you, would you want to be awake or asleep when you die?
Yeah, and sparked a conversation about us like getting older and wanting to get older or not wanting to get older, and one of like all the different downfalls and of getting older, like both physically and mentally.
Yeah, that just makes me think, like when you're, you know, on your last stage of life, when you're on your last leg, do you want to know that you're dying? Do you want to? Because some part of me just thinks that it's going to be a lot more painful if I remember. But at the same time, there's just a conflict that arises there because, of course I want to remember.
I mean, I feel like it would be safe to say that no one really wants to know that that those stages mean that you're dying. But maybe there's a comfort to it.
Maybe. I don't know. It's just like an empty bliss.
I've seen a lot of like things on like social media and Instagram and stuff where people will play like a certain music or certain video and it'll like bring things back, right? And there was one thing that I saw that really stood out to me, and it was like, it's gonna sound really stupid, but it was something saying like there's gonna be a day that like you play Minecraft for the last time, like you load it up for the last time, and that really made me think like there's gonna be a lot of things in our life that we're gonna do for the last time. And I think
that's painful.
It's not only painful, but what's something you're afraid of doing for the last time and forgetting about it?
I mean, to be honest, this is kind of like, so this is kind of obvious, but like, you know, it's just stuff like little things, honestly, like maybe hanging out with the bros, just hanging out with my family. I don't know, just a lot of sentimental things like family and friends based, I suppose, because obviously memory loss, it's going to suck that we're going to forget Minecraft or whatever. But I think in some universe I'm living without ever playing Minecraft. There's a lot of good memories there, but obviously, to me at least, it's not more powerful than like family and just people in general, I guess. And that's the harsh part, because again, going back to what you're saying about how not only is it we're going to see it in us, but we're going to see it in our family too at some point. So not only is there going to be a last time that maybe I remember, I don't know, hugging my brother or something like that, there's going to be a last time, blank family member, there's going to be a last time they remember hugging me. There's going to be a time where they forget me in general. And that's like just obviously tragic. But yeah, mine are mostly people-based. Obviously, I have an attachment to art or whatever. Like, I have my favorite bands and such. But again, there's likely a life where I'm living without my favorite bands. It's going to be tragic to forget, like, the Strokes or whatever. But, you know, it's just not as important to me as people.
Yeah. See, now I feel a little selfish because I wasn't really thinking about people. And I think maybe that's just something I didn't think about at all. And I think it's something maybe that I don't want to think about, because I don't want to get to that, or I don't want things to get to that point. But recently, something ticked in my head, and I just kind of went off, and I started like just talking to, or sending out like a message to people that I haven't talked to in a long time, or people that I think forgot about me. But I mean, I was honestly thinking about it, and it was like, some of these people I haven't talked to in years, and I just hold on to stuff that I want to forget. I hold on to stuff that shouldn't affect me, but it does. And I don't know where I'm going with this tangent. I don't know how this is relevant, but there were some people that I also text to. I wasn't on bad terms. We just stopped talking, and I text my brother, just like telling him I miss him, basically. And I recently started talking to my mom because I don't have the best relationship with my parents, and I recently started talking to her because I don't want to what happened.
To not have her.
Yeah, like as we talked about in the last season, like my grandma passed away to COVID, and I didn't get the chance to talk to her before she passed, and I don't remember the last time I talked to her, and I don't want that to happen again. I don't want the memory of them to be, I wasn't there for them, or I wasn't acknowledging them.
But that just reminds me, just because at the same time, it's like, eventually I'm gonna forget all of this. Do I want to remember it? Like, let's say there's people in my past who I, it was a good time. I think it was a good time, whatever, that we had. Nothing too negative about certain memories haunt me, but the fact that they're not here with me anymore, and I'm not living it anymore, it's kind of more painful to remember those good times. And I think it would be a lot less painful if I just wiped it out of my memory.
Mm-hmm. And that's what I mean by, like, when you brought up people, and I've said that, like, I didn't think of that. It's just, I forget things a lot, and it's just because I don't want to remember them. And I don't do that intentionally. It's just, that's the way my brain copes or handles things. It just forgets it.
Yeah. See, I'm forgetful of everything that I don't care to know, I guess. Like, everything. Well, I mean, that just makes sense, that everything, some, like, things that matter to you more, you're gonna remember more. So that's kind of just a blank statement, because I think anybody could relate to that. But at the same time, what I'm saying is, like, those memories that matter more, that mean the world to me, it's gonna really hurt. It hurts right now just remembering them, just carrying them with me, knowing that those times are gone and that I am not that person I was back in that day. I'm not in that same probably good mindset that I was back in that day. And I love those memories a lot, but I really cannot wait to forget. I think it's going to be a really good time when I forget it all.
See, I feel like I'm the opposite. I feel like I've lived a lot of things that I want to forget. And then when I do remember them, I dread it and I want to forget it again. But when I remember it, it's just like, it just stays there and I can't get rid of it. And I feel like most of my life I've wanted to forget. And maybe that's why, like, I have kind of bad memory, but at the same time, I don't. I have like a weird memory. Like the weirdest things trigger my memory. Like there's just some, I can't think of an example right now, but there's just some really like massive stretches that I think of this thing and somehow I remember this thing from like 8 years ago or whatever, you know, like totally unrelated things.
We're going to take a short PSA break, but we'll be back here on Delta College Radio 93.5 KWDC. You have the floor.
There are everyday actions to help prevent the spread of respiratory diseases. Wash your hands. Avoid close contact with people who are sick. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. Stay home when you are sick. Cover your cough or sneeze. Clean and disinfect frequently touched objects with household cleaning spray. For more information, visit cdc.gov/COVID-19. This message brought to you by the National Association of Broadcasters and this station.
In healthcare, misinformation can be as deadly as the most serious disease and spread just as quickly. For years now, myths about childhood immunizations have been spreading on the internet and social media. The physicians of the Illinois State Medical Society urge parents to know the facts and get your child immunized. Immunizations are scientifically proven to be safe and effective, and failure to immunize can harm your children and others. Talk to your child's doctor to get the facts about immunizations.
If you came across someone struggling with hunger, how would you recognize them? By their clothes? Their age? The way they speak? Would you notice an 8-year-old girl who's not excited for summer break
because she may not be having lunch again until September?
Or a single father of two who works three
part-time jobs and still can't put enough food on the table?
Or maybe a mother who cleans offices at night,
hoping to find meeting leftovers to take home to her hungry family?
Or a war veteran who's having a hard time
landing a job and getting back on his feet?
I am the one in 8 Americans who struggle with hunger. People you pass by every day but never knew were hungry. I am hunger in America.
Hunger can be hard to recognize. Learn why at IamHungerInAmerica.org. Brought to you by Feeding America, 200 Food Bank Strong, and the Ad Council.
So with like dementia and stuff, you figure, you know, it's like the last leg of life. People are dying, but at the same time, it's as if they're already dead. There's no memory attached to them. And without memory, we're kind of, like we said, like almost nothing, an empty shell. But you figure, you go back you know, a long time where we're not as technologically advanced as we are now. People would be dead by then. People, by the time they even reach that stage, they would be dead. And I think the advancements of society, the technological advancements we have, keep us alive way too long. And I think people, no, that sounds harsh, but you're practically dead at that point. It's only thanks to technology that you're still alive, I think.
Yeah.
That's just a scary thought because they really are, you know, empty shells of people that mm-hmm. once were. And I don't mean it like they're as good as dead, but face it.
Have you noticed that it's like, it's a lot harder to forget the things you don't want to remember, but a lot easier to forget the things you want to remember?
No, it's the opposite for me. Like, you're saying for you it's easier to remember the bad things and it's harder to remember the good?
Yeah.
It's opposite for me. I, the good times stay with me longer, I think. But, like, again, it seems like our perception of this is completely different, whereas you want to remember the... No, you want to forget the bad things, and I kind of want to forget the good things.
Why? Why do you want to forget the good things, though? Is it because there's better things to remember? There's going to be better things to remember?
It's just I'm a super nostalgic person, and I feel like it's written all over season one
of
Unknown Space, and even just in every poem I write, it's always rooted in missing something, and I'm just too nostalgic that just me remembering all these good times, I feel like I'm moving nowhere and just at a very slow pace. Oh, go ahead.
I didn't notice that until you just said it. That's what a lot of season one was about. Like me talking about the things that I want to forget and things that really like that from the past that I don't want to be with me anymore. And a lot of the things you talked about was, I think you talked a little bit about it. And I think I talked a little bit about things I want to remember. But that is a lot of what was happening. I didn't think of that.
That being said, like, there's a big chunk of our lives that both of us want to forget. And they are both good and they are bad as well. But at the same time, my friend asked me this because we were just... It's the same friend who showed me that project and all. Man, what are we without our memories?
Yeah.
Because what are we?
That's all anything really is just a memory. Like, everything's always in the past.
Yeah. Without it, we are really just an empty shell, I think.
That's what you kind of see people turn into.
That's the scary part.
Yeah. They're kind of just there. They're just vessels.
What's something you're afraid of doing for the last time and forgetting?
Something that I'd definitely be afraid of forgetting or doing for the last time would be having genuine feelings of empathy towards people around me or towards the music I listen to. Because I genuinely just like enjoy listening to my friends or just people around me whenever they have like some problems. I feel much more connected to them if I'm able to listen to them and feel at least to some degree the emotion that they are feeling. And so if I were to lose that ability, I would definitely feel less connected to my friends and just to the world, I guess.
What's something you're afraid of doing for the last time and forgetting?
I am afraid of forgetting to talk to the people I love. Once everyone around you becomes strangers and you stop talking to everyone, what if you lose that connection forever? Or what if you don't know it's going to be the last time you talk to that person and then you never get to say what you need to say or even just be there for that person? And it could be anyone. It could be family or friends, people you love. I just never want to forget the people I love.
Unknown Space Radio, Season 2, Year of the Fool has been a production of KWDC 93.5 LPFM, Delta College Radio. This program is made possible by listeners like you. Programming is produced by the students, staff, and faculty of San Joaquin Delta College's Radio Television Department. Tom Argonda, Alex Salon, it is supported by the Delta College Department of Arts, Humanities and Multimedia, the Career Technical Education and Workplace Development Office, and the State of California. Thank you for listening. Unknown Space Radio. Tom Argonda. Alex Salon.